Welcome back everyone to the Xamarin Show. Today we have a little Xamarin Forms 101. We're gonna be taking a look at dynamic and static app resources. Now, app resources and resources in general are a great way of defining a style, a set of values, colors, themes, and apply them across multiple controls, multiple pages, or your entire application. What's great is that you no longer have to hard code values inside your application and copy them and paste them around. You create some resources and reuse those throughout your app. Now, I love this because I could do dynamic styling, just specify multiple themes on my application. Just in general, it makes it easier to maintain. You can do this for fonts, colors, anything that you can set inside or on a control. So let's hop over to Visual Studio and take a look. So here's my app that I've been messing around with. It enables me to come in, specify a number, and increase the count by that number that I've entered. So let's say we want to go ahead and increase and change some of the different values here. Instead of this white background, maybe a different color there. So what I can do is come into my main page of this application, and I'm going to say contentpage.resources. And this has a resource dictionary. So the resource dictionary will allow me to specify multiple resources. So here, I'm gonna say, well, I could specify a style, a color, even on platform. I could say X colon and do booleans and bytes and double, all sorts of different stuff. Fonts if I wanted to, anything that you wanna specify. But I'm just gonna do a color, and I'm gonna say X colon key. And the key is what I will use later on inside of my binding, if you will, to this color. So let's say main color. And this will just be red because it's really easy to see. We can do another color here and we'll say X colon key. And I'll say second color and we'll make that blue. There we go. That could be anything inside of there. Those are just predefined Xamarin Forms colors. So here for instance, now on my stack layout for the whole page, I'll say background color. And instead of doing a binding or just hard coding in red or blue, I'll say static resource. And that static resource will be my main color. On the button, let's go ahead and do a background color there. As you guessed it, static resource, second color. So now we should see those kind of red and blue, beautiful colors that I've defined here inside of my resource dictionary. Now this is nice because again, even though it is red and blue, if I am setting these resources on multiple controls, I only have to change it in one place. That's what I really like about it. So our splash page will come up. Here's a beautiful red color that we have inside of here, and the button works as expected. So let's spice this up a little bit more. So for instance, maybe I want this to be, I want that to be white as my main color, and we'll paste a little bit more code in here. What I've done is specified a few more colors like heading text color and normal text color, but I've also created something called a style. A style allows me to define multiple properties in the resource dictionary. So in this one, I have this label page heading style, and it has a target type of label. So this could be a view, it could be a button, but here I'm gonna say this is a label so I can specify that it's bold, it's in the center. And what I wanna also do is set a static resource to the heading text color of black, which is pretty cool. So resources are referencing resources. So now what I can do is on this label, for instance, here, I'll say style, and this will be, you guessed it, a static resource to label page heading style. That's it. So now we can go ahead and run this application again. And what we'll see is that this new label page heading style has been applied across this label that we've just had with the black as the heading text color. So let's go and see this here as this spins up. Now we have white as our background color, much more legible. And we can see now our two is bold right in the middle. I could set font sizes, do anything I want, and I still have my blue here. Now you may be saying, James, that's great because you're on a single page, but how do I put it inside and across multiple pages? It's a great question, very easy to solve. All I have to do is go into my app XAML. My app XAML supplies shared application-wide resources for my entire application. So you want to be selective because this will load up when your application loads, so only the essentials there that you're going to use across multiple pages. But what's really nice is I could just take all of these styles and simply paste them directly in to my resources. So of course I need a resource dictionary, paste them right in there, and now everything is visible to me on any page of my application across it. Now, what's even cooler is that you can access these from the code bind. So if I say app.current.resources, we'll see that I have a resource dictionary back. So you can access them even from your code behind. Now that's the app wide, and if I'm on the page wide, I just say resources. So app.current.resources or resources based if they're in your page. And there you have it. In just a few lines of code, we're creating reusable, beautiful XAML to style our controls, reuse those colors, and anything else that you want to do using resources at a page level and an app level. Now, this is just one of many episodes that I have in my Xamarin.Forms mini-series 101 to get you started building beautiful cross-platform iOS and Android apps with Xamarin.Forms. Of course, go down to the show notes where you find the whole mini-series, but also give us a like if you're on YouTube, and don't forget to subscribe on YouTube or Channel 9 so you get updated with the latest and greatest Xamarin shows right in your inbox. Thanks for watching, and I hope that you enjoyed it, and I see you next time.